Welcome back to Maintenance Monday. Today, I'm going to give you a quick run through of what Threadlock is and how it's applied to our bikes. Nice and simple. Let's do this. Threadlock is a single component adhesive which is applied onto the threads of the fasteners of our bikes. So that's all the screws, nuts and bolts that hold everything together. And Threadlock occurs through electrochemical activity. So that's when it's applied onto the metal components of your bikes, and then that will cause it to cure or dry, or set as well, which is commonly referred to. Threadlocker is actually an anaerobic component, so that means it cures without the presence of oxygen. Because it relies on that electrochemical activity to set the threadlocker, it must be applied to a clean and oil-free thread, otherwise you run the risk of it not setting correctly. Threadlockers are available in a number of different strengths, so that's how strong the adhesive will cure, and then how difficult it is to remove off your bike. And this is indicated by the color which is on the bottle. So purple, which is this one here, is referred to as the weakest one. So that doesn't take so much force to break that free. And then the next one up, we've got blue, and then further up from that is red. Each of these will vary depending on the manufacturer of the thread lock, but it gives you a bit of an indicator of where to go from. Typically, our bikes use fairly low torque settings on most of the different components. So the sort of threadlock that we would use on our bikes would be the purple or the blue. So the purple requires approximately 7 Nm to break its hold on the thread, whereas the blue one is a bit stronger, so we require about 15 Nm. This will, of course, vary with the different brands, as I just said. So make sure you check the different strength of the threadlocker that you've got, because we certainly don't want any parts getting stuck onto your bike. Threadlock is particularly important for the components which have a rather low torque setting, but we need to be assured that they're going to remain in place. So items such as our handlebar clamp, for example, or the bolts on the stem of our bike. We want to be assured that they're going to stay in place. Another area that we almost always see threadlocker applied to are the bolts or the components of our brake calipers, for example. Again, we need to be assured that they're going to stay in place. In addition to that threadlocking compound, on the bolts that hold the caliper onto the bike, you'll quite often also see a mechanical device helping to hold it in place. Items such as a little clip or a circlip on the end of the bolt, just to make sure it's got that additional bit of security. In addition to preventing accidental loosening of the fasteners on our bikes, threadlock will also prevent leaks, resist corrosion, and act as a lubricant when you're doing that fastener up. But you don't need to apply threadlock onto every single component of your bike, so I wouldn't worry about putting it on your bottle cage bolts, for example. But any component on our bike that should have threadlocker on it, well, it would have been installed at the factory when your bike was assembled. So if you're removing any components on your bike to complete maintenance or service it, for example, and you notice that that had threadlock on, well, when you go to refit it, just apply a little bit of threadlock and you've got peace of mind that it's as it should be. Before I run through how to apply threadlock onto the bolts or the fasteners on our bikes, first up, I've got two different examples here. So this one is the purple, so the lower strength one. It's actually in a liquid form. So inside here, nice runny liquid. Then we can undo the nozzle and then carefully apply it onto the thread of the components of our bikes. This one here is actually a completely different type. So this is almost like a paste. So here you just do this thread up, guide that out, and then you can just apply it onto the thread. And because it's not liquid, you don't run the risk of it running into places that you didn't want in the first place. So nice and easy, you can take your pick between which one suits your needs best. To apply threadlocker, it's super easy. So like I said earlier, the first thing you need to do is ensure that the components, so the thread on them, is nice and clean and free of any oil or other contaminants. Obviously this is just a brand new bolt with a fixing here, but if you've taken a component off your bike, clean it thoroughly and then make sure it's nice and dry. If you want to help make life a little bit easier, you could just use a little bit of disc brake cleaner. So then once we take our threadlock component, so I'm going to use the liquid one here to make it nice and easy, and you just quite simply apply 1-2 drops, so a fair bit came out there, onto the thread like that. You don't need to worry about putting it all the way along or spreading it around everywhere, providing you put it towards the end of the thread. As you fit the other component or thread it in, like so, as it contacts the threadlock, it will spread around by itself automatically and then go into all of the places that you need it to be. And if you've got any excess left, like I've got here, you can just quite simply get a cloth, wipe it off and let it dry. Usually, within a few minutes, this will start to cure or set, and the full strength of the threadlocker is achieved after a number of hours, leaving it to dry. To apply the different type of threadlock, so this one is the thicker one, which is in a bit of a paste form, we can just take the same principle. So we've got a nice clean threaded bolt here, apply a little bit of this onto the ends. So again, we don't need to put loads on, just enough to cover the edge of the bolt where the thread was going to be. Then we'll get the other component, match them together, do exactly the same as what we did the first time. So we just do them up. And here you can wipe off any excess again, just make sure we've got a nice clean finish. Go ahead and torque the bolt up or the component on your bike to its recommended torque setting. There's no need to change it to anything different, add or remove any torque. Do it up as is recommended, and after a bit of time, this will gradually cure and hold everything in place. And you don't have to worry about accidental loosening of any different fasteners. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have, please do give it a big thumbs up. And if you've got any other maintenance videos you'd quite like to see, well, let me know in the comments section down below, and I'll see what I can do. See ya!